Welcome back to Let's Play Star Trek Echoes from the Past. I am the RPG Chick, and we have to help the USS Nakatomi. Let's go see if Picard has anything to say. We had better make good speed to the ship in orbit around Titris Iota 4. It looks like the Romulans have made their move. Alright. Titris Iota 4? Tetris? What? So Iota is actually a, you know, I don't even know what you call these, this kind of, it's not Roman, but Latin numbers or something? There's the freighter. Now can I increase to warp point 2? Yes. Engage. See how close we are? These are not exactly seconds. greetings? Hello, Captain. Don't tell me that you are surprised to find us here. I have no time to play guessing games. Why are you in Federation space? Well, I think I can make an educated guess. Yeah, why are you in Federation space? Don't play the fool with me, Picard. When Starfleet prevented us from looking for our comrades in Federation space, did you think we would simply abandon them? Your callousness is appalling. Alright, come on. It takes so long to get over here. Are photons affected? I can't just move out of the way of these things. They seek. They home in. Alright. Do mine home in then? Yeah, our photons are damaged. And I don't want to leave this screen to repair them and just get destroyed. Photons are being repaired. I can see now. Oh, we're running out of photons, something like that. Oh, so we are evading some of them. The phasers are not here. Yeah, I suck at this game. Ow! Big pain! Yeah, we're really not doing well. After suffering heavy damage and only narrowly escaping, the Enterprise is unable to continue its mission without assistance from Starfleet. I don't know how long it's gonna take for them. They might have gotten lucky hits through and... You know what? Hold on. My god, the screen tearing is insane. Engineering. I'm wondering if I need to allocate my resources differently. 275 photons? Is that the limit for the entire game? No, I think when you stop at a starbase, they refill your photons, so it's good I did that at least. Pretty damn sure. Anyway. Okay, I guess just try again. 4. Just gonna save right here. Okay. This is the guy from before. So far, so good. I'm gonna resave. Oh, I didn't select this. Alright. Let's do that now, since we're right here. Can we examine this thing before we answer the hail? Cool. Name, Nakatomi. I should examine Starbase too, that'd be cool. So it's a freighter class ship from Federation Registry NCC-4721. 33 life forms, human life forms on board. Interstellar technology, shields, deflector screens, forward energy deflector array. Hull is buttressed titanium. Weapons, not available. Shields, 100%. Hull, 34%. Current cargo, electronic instruments. Really? Federation fools, go away. If you don't, do not go away, we will make you... Sorry. Federation fools, go away. If you do not go away, we will make the hostages go away forever. Sorry, I don't speak imbecile. You have hijacked a Federation freighter. A violation of interstellar law. Ooh, we got three choices? Chodak Commander? What? Chodak Commander, let us discuss an exchange of the hostages for something you need. Number one... Okay, I'm a little confused. The Chodak really looked nothing like this. I guess... No, really, they didn't really look anything like this. Even out of their shell. We just came across these guys in the previous game I just played, a Final Unity. The DOS game. The Chodak, but they had shells and they were basically like, they were like mollusks. They lived inside shells and they came from out of the sea. And then grew to, you know, make their own technological shells, which had like weapons and such. Shields of their own, I think. This is the starship USS Enterprise. You will release the hostages immediately and surrender yourselves to our authority. Now, how would we even know, first of all, discounting the look, how would we know that this is a Chodak? I guess we just know of them. Yeah, I'll say this one then. You have hijacked, because I don't think this is happening. You have hijacked a Federation freighter, a violation of interstellar law. Laws? What are laws? Laws protect the weak. Yes, and you need to be using question marks when appropriate. Laws ensure the peace. Lower your shields immediately. Oh, so we're just yelling at each other. It is you who lack strength. That vessel has no weapons. True, yeah, where's their own vessel? I'm gonna choose this. That vessel has no weapons. You test the Chodak? Test the strength of our explosive devices? Do you wish to see the death of the hostages? If those people are touched, you will deal with the entirety of the Federation. This is not your region of the galaxy. Or most certainly not. There must be some peaceable resolution to this situation. I'll choose this. The best solution is for you to leave and not follow. The hostages will be released at a future time, unharmed. Those terms are unacceptable, Captain. Well, one moment. We are prepared to strike a bargain. In exchange for the safe release of all of the hostages, we will guarantee your safety to any destination within Federation space. Terms are unacceptable. They are the only terms. Do not stop us. Out. Slow down. Oh, we're gone. They are gone. Like we didn't even see them leave gone. Captain's log. Having responded to a distress call from the captain of the... Oh! You know I'm gonna save here. We have the end of the last episode to go back to, so it's not that far back. If this is an inescapable, like, an unwinnable confrontation. So I'm just gonna save here. I think I can make an educated guess. That's right, Picard. We are looking for our missing research team. Since I am in no mood to start a war, we return to the neutral zone. Out. Oh. Well, that was easy. Okay, can we go over the captain's log again? Oh, I lost it! I mean... You guys can go back and read that if you want. And I'm gonna do that after I'm finished recording this episode. But there was... pretty sure there was more to scroll down and look at, and I didn't get to see it. My god. My god, man. Standard patrol. I don't know what the hell to do. Oh, we have communications, so well, let's answer the hail. That's what we'll do. What? DTX 151284. Romulan Star Empire, coded. From Romulan Command, Warbird Hatona, engaged in battle with alien vessel at Lothos 7. Alien vessel appears similar to previously encountered vessels. Maintain positions. Alien is secondary priority. Repeat, secondary priority. Reinforcements en route and transmission. Okay, cool. Now this is the codes that we got from Damon Radney. So can we make... Do we have a Lothos 7 we can go to? Probably we need Lothos V11. Oh, we got another! Enterprise, this is Dr. Talaris. Come to CODIS New 6. I have discovered the function of the Tavad. Out. Cool. Set a course back to CODIS New 6. Dr. Talaris has new information concerning the IFD and the use of the Tavad. Okay. Long-range scanners have detected disturbance in the Veranitoris sector. Federation vessel, let us pass. We have important business affairs to conduct, and we are behind schedule. Not so fast, my friends. This is Captain Jean-Luc Picard of the Enterprise. State your business in this sector and transmit a cargo manifest for our inspection. I'm going to choose this one. This is Captain Picard. Do not forget that you are a guest in Federation space. Our goal is merely to protect the peace. We have perishable cargo aboard. Cargo anxiously awaited by our clients. Our trade benefits the common good. You cannot deny this. Out. Whatever. It's an awful busy day in space, is it? So we got back to... I want to see if there is a Lothos cluster? No, we don't have a Lothos. So they're either using different names than we do, which would make sense. Not everyone has to use CODIS and Varanator for stuff. Or it's most probably a location in Romulan space. So CODIS... Sheesh. What is it? Hold on. CODIS New 6. That's Korax. And away we go. Yummy. They have a Starbucks aboard this vessel. It is very choice. Okay. Getting close? I guess we've had enough, you know, instances of communication and such. Encounters. Distance 75.25. We're only getting farther away. Well, now we're here. Okay. Captain's log. Yet again, the Enterprise is in orbit around CODIS New 6. Dr. Talaris informed us that she has discovered the functioning of the device given to us by the Unations. I can only hope I have made the right decision coming here instead of investigating the usual signals. The unusual signals emanating from the Varanator cluster. I don't know if it's the music, or the font, or the way I'm reading. Probably the way I'm reading this. We really only have three or four words to a line. I have a hard time reading it aloud, as you guys may have noticed. That said, I will continue to put forth my best efforts. And, energize. Yay, I love this song. Would you like to come with us? I think that's Chan. Greetings! Your return is well timed. I have news for you. Well, it's timed like that because you bade us to return. And we as well, Doctor. Excellent. What of the Tavad? Let's just ask her this. I don't think it matters. We got a question mark followed by a period. Tavad stands for Temporary Artificial Variable Anomaly Device. This device navigates through subspace anomalies. I'm not sure I follow you, or... Yeah, let's choose this one. Subspace anomalies are extremely rare and little understood phenomena. Whoever built the Tavad understood them quite well. It is projected much like a photon torpedo, and it's programmable. This one has already been directed to seek the IFD. Really? Then it's operational. While I don't doubt our engineering skills, it's risky to test something so alien on the Enterprise. How will it do that? How will it do that, yeah. The Tavad is programmed to lock onto a beacon, a signal from the IFD. However, the fuel supply of this Tavad has run dry. It needs fresh supplies of polentium and ravarium. I have that. I have that stuff. Your service has been duly noted, Dr. Talaris. Or... yes. So we got all this stuff in the caves. I'm glad it's actually of some use in the mining caves. That was a pain in the butt. We have recently encountered a source for plantium and vivarium, Doctor. We will indeed be able to discover if this Tavad works. The machine includes a self-diagnostic function. The results were consistent with perfect operation. The Tavad is safe for it is ready to for, the Tavad is ready for return. Away team to Enterprise. The Tavad has been retrieved. Four to beam up. I don't know why I always try that. According to the Vulcan archaeologist, Dr. Talaris, the Tavad is designed to stabilize areas of space not subject to the normal laws of nature. With a fully functioning Tavad, she believes it will be possible for a vessel to successfully navigate the subspace anomaly recently reported in the Varenitor cluster. She is also certain that the answer to the mystery surrounding the Senatorius and the IFD lies at the other end of this anomaly. I cannot help having certain reservations about using this device. It is, after all, completely untested. I feel, however, that if there is even a hint of truth about the awesome power of the IFD, the journey through the subspace anomaly is of the utmost importance. It is indeed fortunate that we obtained the minerals needed to activate the Tavad when we were at that mine on Orion's Gamma 3B. We can now go directly to the Varenitor cluster, and perhaps unveil the whole story behind the IFD. Varenitor cluster, okay. Where in the Varenitor cluster? It's actually, I found it's not a good idea to save in the menu of the con. Ooh, subspace anomaly. Excessive travel time. Well, cool. It's either excessive travel time or safe warp exceeded. How about warp 7? We'll just, like, repair. We'll see, you know, how much damage this really does, and we'll repair as needed. We don't use the warp engines during battle, right? So we can just do that. Oh my! Human, do not stop our passage through this backward sector of the galaxy. Identify yourselves and convince me that your business here is peaceful. Then you may continue uninterrupted. This is Captain Picard of the USS Enterprise. You must realize that I am obliged to protect Federation space from unknown intruders. Good. Soon, everyone will know of the Chodak. Soon, the Chodak will not be intruders. This sector will soon belong to the Chodak. This is the last intrusion you will have to deal with. Now, we will crush you. Yeah, you probably will. It takes me forever just to get over to tactical. Oh my, there's more than one. Oh, we're doomed. Run away! We must flee! Well, I got the one shields down. I don't know who to fi- we just fire on whoever's closest, obviously. Yeah, we're- this is not gonna work. Maybe we can just warp whenever they appear, that'd be cool. Our engines are damaged, that's why I'm not moving. Yeah. Okay, here. Here's the log. 4 interrupted. So you guys can pause if you want. There's that, and that, and that, and now I'm gonna read it. See if I can get through it. Captain's log. Having responded to a distress call from the captain of the Federation freighter Nakatomi, the Enterprise has encountered an unknown alien race. Unfortunately, they seem to be extremely hostile. They have taken the freighter by force and are keeping its crew hostage. Can I keep reading? In a communication with a being that seemed to be their leader, I attempted to get this alien to lower the freighter's shields. Tragically, I was unsuccessful. The vessel escaped with all the hostages aboard. The path of the freighter was tracked, but mysteriously vanished somewhere in the Venator cluster. I can only hope that the crew are still alive. Okay. Dr. Talaris. Okay, trying again for the Venator cluster. Particularly the subspace anomaly. I'm gonna have excessive travel time. I'm just gonna try to warp away from these people. I don't think I can defeat them. If I do, it'll be through a fluke or something. So I'll try that. That's a Ferengi vessel. Why do you hail us? We are traitors. We've done nothing wrong. Unless you find commerce itself so offensive that you must stop it at every turn. This is Captain Jean-Luc Picard. We seek information, nothing more. There has been a great deal of movement lately on the Romulan side of the neutral zone. Can you shed any light on this matter? Or... You are accused of no wrongdoing. We are on standard patrol, and this is a routine check. Your ship seems rather heavily armed for a trading vessel. Can you explain? Let's ask us if they can shed any light on the matter. Negative. This ship does not trade in Romulan territory. Some Ferengi traders do. I'm sure they can help you for a fee. Out. I have a feeling we would have been attacked. If we, had asked the other question. They really don't like us looking through their stuff. Or questioning them about it. So we are quite far away. Distance seems to decrease and then increase. And now it's increasing. Not sure what to do about that. Time is increasing as well. Oh, yet here we are. Oh. Hello? I am Jean-Luc Picard. What have you done to me? Oh, molten lava. Picard does not like lava. No one likes lava. What are these random sounds? Well, I'm guessing this is supposed to happen. I'll just save here. I notice I do not have a phaser. Arena. We're in Quake. Lava. This is all arena? This is arena too? This is arena. I'm Picard, not a gladiatorial combatant. Still arena. What the hell, this faces? Well, the decor is certainly interesting. Picard's getting flashbacks of Locutus of Borg times. Hello? Transporter pad. Speak? Holographic display. I was supposed to go there? Okay, I guess so. What the fraggin? It's faces. Whirling, dizzy faces. They're about to puke on us. So, you have arrived. 10,000 years have passed since the last test. Perhaps one of you has the strength, wisdom, and compassion to lead the galaxy into a new age of peace. For peace is the purpose of the IFD. Its creators, the Senatorius, fell to the temptation of using the IFD for evil. They recovered and, armed with the knowledge of evil, sent the device into the future. The future is now. You will be tested for the three qualities of leadership: strength, wisdom, and compassion. Scattered on worlds in this system are three kinds of shard, each kind representing one of the qualities of leadership. Right, which are strength, wisdom, and compassion. Find them and return here for the final test. The test of the IFD. Let us begin. The test of strength is first. Find the lonely frozen moon to start your quest. The lonely frozen moon. Okay, so it's an iced over moon. And it's a lonely moon because there's only one of it. That's all I can say. And bye-byes. Picard? Instigate a search for a lonely moon in the Venator cluster. We are going to take part in the tests set by the Senatorius. Okay, so it's definitely the Senatorius then. Anything interesting about the star? Alright, if it's any different from the average star, I have no idea then. Oh, we have to find a moon. A lonely moon. We got three. Wait. Yeah, these are all moons. This doesn't have any moons. Let's skip to Delta. Just in case they're counting on us going... Ah! Venator Delta 1A, then. Or, yeah, Delta 1A. Warp 6.2, engage! Departing immediately. Please let us head for our frozen, lonely moon. You know, this might be... That's a blue star? Oh wait, that's the planet. Well, that is a blue star. This might not be a frozen moon. But I say continue heading there just the same. How will we know? Unsafe. Okay, so this is not it, because... This moon... Temperature is terrestrial. Not frozen or Arctic or anything like that, so... That's not it. Probably because of the blue star, which is the brightest burning star. So, let's head... Check out the other deltas. We are here. No moons. A lot of moons. Two more. Okay, so it's not any of the deltas. Try beta. No moons. We'll try this one. This is a yellow star, and it looks rather far away, doesn't it? So we'll try this one. Oh! Prepare to be boarded. We claim your vessel in the name of the Chodak Empire. We have never heard of the Chodak Empire. This territory is claimed by the United Federation of Planets. We are a peaceful association of planets in this region of the galaxy. Wait. We're waiting. We're waiting. You are lucky. Other business has come up. We have no time to take your weak ship. Wait and we will return. Ha! Huh. I ain't waiting for crap. We are continuing to this hopefully frozen moon. Who'd know I have this much reading to do in a Sega Genesis game? Oh, let's get the hell out of here. Oh, crap. Oh,